Hello students, today we shall going to discuss with reference to the main important features of sexuality of organisms. The determination of sexuality of an organism at molecular level is purely designated as sexuality. In most of the primitive sexually reproducing organisms, there is no morphological or physiological difference in the functional gametes. In case of primitive organisms, if the gametes are present on the same plant, such organisms are called homothallic. Such a condition is seen in case of mucor. It is a type of filamentous fungi. In some cases, the gametes are present on different plants. Such organisms are called heterothallic organisms. One of the classical examples for the heterothallic organism is another filamentous fungi called rhizopus. With reference to higher organisms, the sex organs are well developed and they have male and female, and they develop into male and female organisms. In higher flowering plants, both male and female sex organs are present on the same flower. Then the condition is said to be the monoecious or bisexual. You can find the presence of male anther, female, that is ovary, is seen in a single flower, in the same flower. The condition is called monoecious or bisexual. It is naturally seen in case of sweet potato comprising of male and female sex organs. Comprising of male and female sex organs. Such a condition is seen in case of sweet potato. In some plants, the male and the female flowers are born on different plants. Such a type of plants are popularly designated as dioecious, or it is also designated as unisexual. Such a type of flowers are naturally seen in case of date palm and in case of papaya. Because of the unisexual condition, only the female flowers have the potentiality to bear the fruits. You can find the presence of fruits only in few plants of the papaya that are purely female. Such a condition is seen in case of papaya and also in case of date palm. The next important aspect is with reference to certain monoecious and dioecious plants. If both the male and the female flowers are present on the same plant, then the condition is said to be the monoecious. Then the condition is said to be the monoecious condition. Naturally, you can find the presence of monoecious plants. Our monoecious condition is seen in case of maize, coconut, pinus, and also in case of cocoa pits. If you consider a coconut, in the bottom of the flower, you can find the presence of female flowers. Toward the terminal region, you can find the presence of male flowers. You can find the presence of male flowers. Such a condition is seen in case of coconut, and similar type of condition is seen in case of maize also. characterized by the presence of staminate and pistillate flowers. The second important aspect is dioecious plants. In certain plants, both the male and the female flowers are present on different plants. Then they are said to be the dioecious plant. Naturally, you can find the presence of dioecious plants in case of marcasium, date palm, and also in case of papaya, you can find the presence of dioecious conditions. In lower animals, you can find the presence of both the male and the female sex organs are present in the same individual. Such animals are called hermaphrodite, or it is also designated as monoecious or bisexual condition. You can find the presence of hermaphrodite condition in case of tapeworm, sponges, earthworm, and also in case of leaves. With reference to earth, in a single organism, you can find the presence of male and the female sex organs. Such a type of male and female sex organ comprising organisms are purely designated as hermaphrodite. The majority of the animals are unisexual or dioecious in nature, with distinct male and female individuals. The male and the female individuals, they differ remarkably. Such a type of unisexual or dioecious condition is seen in majority of the animals. Naturally, you can find the presence of dioecious condition or unisexual condition in case of Ascaris lumbricoides. You can find the presence of male and female Ascaris lumbricoides. Second one is cockroach, frog, in case of birds, in case of lizards, and also in case of mammals, you can find the presence of unisexual or dioecious condition. This is with reference to the sexuality of organisms. In majority of the competitive examples, they ask certain classical examples with reference to dioecious, unisexual, monoecious, bisexual, or hermaphrodite condition. This is with reference to the main important features of sexuality of organisms. Thank you.